The person we have on our show tonight, Vikram Seth, 41, poet, novelist, travel writer, and super brat of modern Indian literature. He is now in the headlines as one of the world's highest paid authors, who has just earned over 2.5 crore rupees as an advance for his forthcoming book, A Suitable Boy, from American and British publishers. Vikram Seth lives in Noida, publishes worldwide, loves China, quotes from Mir Taqi Mir and Dufu, prefers Jane Austen to Rabindra Sangeet, and sings Shubat leaders. Why did Vikram Seth choose to write in English instead of his mother tongue, Hindi? Is it just because of the big bucks? Let's ask him. Let's find out.
Eine Mühle seh ich blinken aus den Erlen heraus. Durch Rauschen und Singen bricht Rede Gebraus, bricht Rede Gebraus. Ei, willkommen, ei, willkommen, süßer Mühlengesang. Ei, willkommen, ei, willkommen.
He is the author everyone is talking about. For Vikram Seth's new book, A Suitable Boy, will be out any day now. A huge 1,349-page monster of a novel, which reportedly took the 41-year-old author 8 long years to complete. But oddly enough, the publishing hype, hysteria to be more precise, does not center around the quality of Vikram Seth's work. What everyone is talking about is the fact that the manuscript has earned the highest advance ever paid for a first novel, 26 million rupees to be precise. Though Seth himself neither denies nor confirms that figure. Even assuming that he earned nothing during those 8 long years, which is not exactly true, since Seth published a poetic novel, a book of poems, a slim sheaf of translations from Chinese poetry, and a collection of beastly rhymes during those 96 months, not forgetting a little-known libretto, it would mean a staggering 10,000 rupees earned per day, a sum no Indian author has ever dreamt of, leave alone earned. Is this because Vikram writes in English? In fact, to rephrase the question, does Vikram Seth write in English because of the big bucks involved, or, hold on, is he a truly international author, India's first?
Now that's a tricky sort of question, and one that I have finally decided not to fret too much about. I am Indian, I write in English, both these things are completely natural to me, and I personally, my own attitude towards this is a kind of ad hoc attitude. I think if the books are good, read them and don't fuss about academic categories.
Is there any language you are as familiar with as you are with English?
No.
Indian language?
No, I suppose my next best language is Hindi. And Chinese, a long way after that. And when I sing leader, German. But my German is very limited because it largely consists of phrases like, oh, the lilies are wilting. And that wouldn't get me very far if I wanted to buy a ticket to Berlin.
Have you ever tried writing in any other language, Hindi for instance?
Yes, I have a bit. It doesn't come off very well. But then at one stage I felt rather guilty that I didn't know any Indian language or as well as I know English. But then after a while I began wondering, why are you feeling guilty? Do the best you can. If you've been brought up to, say, play the sitar, then you can't at the age of 25 decide, well, this is politically incorrect and I should start playing the sarangi instead. You do what you can, you write about what you must, and you should forget about trying to be politically correct.
Did you spend much time reading Indian literature, or do you spend much time reading Indian literature?
Well, at school, we did study Hindi literature from an anthology called Padyamala, and then there was a balancing anthology called Gadyamala. Now, unfortunately, at that stage, we didn't place very much emphasis on, you know, the poems of, say, Sur Das or Rahim or Kabir. It was just another subject that we had to study. We also did some Sanskrit, but unfortunately, like schoolboys, we were more interested in
passing exams.
I suppose.
I asked this question because you've had a rather peripatetic family.
I suppose we have.
And you've been traveling all over.
True.
All the while.
Yeah.
And there's been a cross-cultural feel to the novel that you've just written.
To the novel I've just written, I suppose so.
And that obviously gives me a feeling that you've been exposed to multiple cultures within India itself.
I was born in Calcutta, brought up there for the first few years of my life. Then the family moved to Patna, lived there for 10 years. I went to school in Dehradun, and then finally we moved to Delhi. And if our family is from anywhere, it's partly from UP, partly from Punjab. So we're obviously exposed to a combination of, you know, Hindu, Islamic, Western culture. And that shouldn't be considered in some sense typical just of our family, but of the way things are, and I think the way things should be in India.